Hi everyone, welcome y'all. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to take screenshots in Playwright. So to capture the screenshot, there are multiple approaches are there and multiple ways we can capture the screenshot in Playwright. And we can capture full page screenshot, and also we can capture a particular section from the page, and sometimes we can capture particular element screenshot. So to do that, we have a method available called screenshot method, which is directly available in the page feature. And by using this method, we can simply capture the screenshot. Okay. Now let me show you how can we use this method to capture full page screenshot. And we can also capture specific area from the page. And also we can capture screenshot of the particular element. Okay. So this is the official document. They have provided all the methods. Let me show you practically how can we use it. So now I'm going to open my VS Code editor. And in this, I already created one file, screenshot.spec.js, and I have created three different tests. So one is for taking a page, and second is for full page, and the third one is for element screen. Okay, fine. So now let me capture the screenshot of the page. So whatever page is appeared on the screen, so we can capture the screenshot of that particular page. Okay, so for example, let me try to open an application. Okay, now okay, just look at this application. So as soon as you open the browser, and you can see a particular page, but it is not full page actually. So whatever page is visible on the browser, we can capture only this particular page. And if you want to capture, you can just complete page also, you can capture including the footer part. But as soon as you can see this part, right? So this page we can capture directly. So for that, what we can do is, and the first test, I'm going to implement this. So first of all, launch my application. I can say await page.goto and specify the URL of application. All right, so this is the URL of application which I'm going to use. And now as soon as I open my page, I want to capture the screenshot of the page. So to capture the screenshot, we can use page feature await page.screenshot. This is the method we have to call. And in this, we have to pass location or path. So how to pass in the curly brace, we can specify the curly brace. We need to add path colon, and you can directly specify the name of the file. You can say, suppose home page, I'll give some name called homepage.png. So this is the file name I have given. So when I leave this statement directly like this, what happens is this particular screenshot will by default will be saved under the particular folder. So I can say Playwright automation, the project folder, right? Inside the project, directly the file will be saved. That is a default. Suppose if you want to save this screenshot file somewhere else, I will maintain all the screenshots in some particular folder. So then we can provide the path. So before that, I already created one screenshot folder here inside my project. Now I want to save all my screenshots inside this folder. So what we can do is, so before specifying this name here, you can just concatenate with the path. You can just provide the relative path. You can just right click on this, copy relative path, and then specify inside the quotations. So this is a path. So in this particular path, and this particular file will be saved. So this is the actual path, and inside this, the file will be saved. Okay. But sometimes what happens is, suppose first time when you run this, the screenshot will be captured and stored this in the same folder. Next time when you run the same test, then what happens? Again, the new screenshot will be saved with the same name. So we cannot maintain the multiple screenshot. It will be replaced with the new file. Old files will be replaced with the new file because the file name is exactly the same. So what we can do is, whenever you capture the screenshot, we can save the screenshot with the timestamp or with the date, time, and minute, so on. We can attach the timestamp to the screenshot file name. And then we can maintain all the screenshots. So for that, what I will do is, instead of directly concatenating with this name, and here I will create a date timestamp. So for that, I can call one method called date.now. So this will actually return the date, and then I'm concatenating the rest of the things. So this is the actual path location where you want to save the screenshot, and this will return the time, and this is the screenshot file. You can put this after the name of the screenshot also, or you can put before the screenshot also. Okay, so whichever way you want, you can just do this. Fine. So now this is a way we can simply specify the statement. So this will capture the screenshot, whichever is displayed on the particular screen. If I look at my screen, it is just giving the main page and the sliders along with some feature products, but it is not displaying the bottom of the page, like footers and everything. It is not displayed, right? So only this particular part, whatever is visible on the page, it will only the capture that particular part. Okay. Now let me just execute my test. So I can just put only, so that second and third one still not implemented. I'm just running my first test. Now go to the file and the save. And here I'm running the file. So my file name is npx playwright test. Inside the test, screenshot.spec.js. And my project is Chromium. I just want to run only in Chromium browser in headed mode. Okay, let's go and execute. Okay, now let's see. So it is got failed, right? So now let's see why it is got failed. Screenshot. So await page.screenshot. And here it is giving some error. So let's see why it is giving an error. And just close this page and go back to VS Code editor. And you can see await page dot screenshot. And here, this is my path variable, path colon, and test slash screenshot slash. And here we have closed the single quotation, and then we have concatenated this date dot now. And again, concatenation, and then homepage.png. Here, additionally, we have given one more concatenation. Actually, this is not required. But this is a simple name of the page. Okay. So this is a mistake we have done. So let me save the file and then execute one more time. Save it. Control C and then execute one more time. Yeah. So now perfectly executed and it's got passed. Right. So where we can see the screenshot file? If I look at this, we already saved the screenshot inside the folder, right? I go back to the screenshot folder and this is the file you can see. When I click on this, you can see only this part you can see. Whatever the part which is displayed on the screen level, only that particular part of the page you can see in this. So here 16, 88, 98, 707, this is a date format, whichever we have given here, date.now. So this is generated that a number and followed by the name of the screenshot. Okay, so this is one approach. We can directly capture the screenshot of the page, and sometimes we can capture the full page of the screenshot. Okay, so for example, I want to capture the bottom part, including the footer and everything. So we can use one more method. So what I can do is I can just copy the same stuff. And there is one more approach which is there. So simply here also what we can do is page.screenshot, and the same thing, path we can specify. And the function which will generate the timestamp. And again, name of the screenshot, this is fine. I can just provide some other name. You can say full page.png. And in addition, we have to pass one more parameter. That is before closing this name, you can just comma. We provide one more option called full page. Full page, the value is true. Okay, this is the value we have to pass along with the name of the screenshot. We should also pass one more option parameter, full page colon true. So this will capture the full page screenshot. Okay, now I'll remove this only. Now here, I can just run only this particular test. Second one, full page screenshot. Okay, now let me run this again. Okay, now it is done, executed, passed, and now you can see the homepage.png, then complete page screenshot is got captured. Let me open one more time. Can just close this. Okay, fullpage.png. And we provided full page colon true, right? Fine. So let's go back and see full page, second one. You can see this is the complete page, including the footer part. The whole page is get captured here, right? In the first page, in the first time, we capture only this much. But in the second time, when you pass full page true option, it will capture the entire page, including the footer part. This is a simple difference. Okay, now there is another approach. There is another way we can capture screenshot. Like if you want to screenshot only particular element. Okay, so then we can do this. So let me execute this one. So only if you want to screenshot of the particular element. So then what we can do? Okay, so in this particular page, I want to capture, let's say, go to this application. In this particular page, I want to capture specific element screenshot or specific area from this web page. Okay, so then how can we capture this? Suppose I want to capture the screenshot of this particular element, MacBook. So first inspect this element. And this is IMG, right? So we need to provide a locator of this element. So go to selector hub and then capture this element. So this is the exact element pointing to the MacBook. And apart from this MacBook, I want to also capture the screenshot of this description of this image. Okay, and then you can just go to this particular div tag, the first div tag, and it's pointing to the image. But again, go to the above one. Yeah, now you can just look at this. This particular entry in the dev tools is pointing the entire product, right? So now I can use this particular tag to point that entire element. Okay, now go back to the selector hub. And you can just see here, this is the relative XPath, which is getting very lengthy XPath. Let me capture like this, copy XPath, and then provide here. So this is an XPath exactly pointing with this element, okay? Now I'm trying to capture the screenshot of only particular, this particular product. So I can capture this. And what you will do is, again, same thing, we repeat. Let me copy this part. And so what is the new change here is, again, we are launching the page. And again, we are passing the location path and date. And this is MacBook. This is a product.png. And we can just remove this parameter. Full page is true. This we have to remove, okay? And what is additional thing we have to provide is, previously we have directly accessed the screenshot method from the page feature, right? From the page feature. So this time we have to capture the screenshot from the locator. So what we can do is, instead of calling the screenshot method directly, we say page.locator. Page.locator, and here provide the locator, then dot screenshot. So here we have to pass the locator. So let me get this locator. So this is an XPath of the product element. And if you go back and then provide the locator here, that's it. So now this will go and get the locator of this element and then capture the screenshot of this element. So here I'm providing some name, MacBook.png. Okay. So this is how we can capture the screenshot of particular element. Now I'm running this test. Go to save and go to terminal and then execute the same thing. screenshot.spec.js. All right, now it is started executing. Now it is got passed. So now we'll see whether it is captured the screenshot of the particular product or not. So where the screenshot will be saved under the screenshot folder, macbook.png. Just click on it. Yes, now you can see this is captured the screenshot of this book. Okay, so this is how we can also capture the screenshot of particular element. So these are the methods which are provided by Playwright. We can capture the screenshot of the page, whichever is displayed on the page, on the screen. Then we can capture the screenshot of the element. We can capture the screenshot of the full page. So apart from these, there is some more options available. Suppose if you want to capture screenshot of particular test, right? Then what we can do is we can write this statement inside the test. In every test, we can write this statement accordingly. Suppose I want to capture the screenshot of every test. Whenever I run the test, I want to capture the screenshot of the test. Okay. So then what we can do is, suppose in my test folder, I have so many tests I have created. So whatever test I want to execute, whenever I want to execute, by default, I want to capture the screenshot. And that should be part of the report also. Okay. And then what we can do is, Playwright is provided some configurations that we need to do. So if I go back here, playwright.config.js file. So this is a configuration file. So in this particular configuration file, we can provide required configuration for the project. So whatever configuration we provided in this file, that is applicable for all the spec files which are present inside the project. Okay. Now, if I look at here and directly go to the block, something called use. okay, this particular block. So in this, there is one option currently it is there, and base URL, all these things we commented. Now, apart from this trace, I will also provide you one more option. Okay, that's called screenshot. This is an option. And I make it as on. So this is one more option which we can write inside this block in the playwright.config.js. So then what happens, whatever test you have executed, whatever spec file you have executed, it will automatically capture the screenshot every time. And that screenshot will be part of the report. Now, let me show you. Let me save the file. And now I have done this configuration. So I will create one more test. Let's go to screenshot2.spec file. So currently I don't have anything. So this time I will write some piece of code, and once executed the test, this will automatically capture the screenshot without writing any code. Okay. So for that, what I'm going to do is I'm trying to use one application here. Await page.goto. So this is the application I'm trying to use. And I will also do some kind of a login, and I will click on the login, and then I will provide username and password, and then click on the login. So for that, I'm going to write some piece of code, go back, and this is a script for login. So first I'm launching the page, and then I'm clicking on the login link, and then I'm providing username, and then I'm providing password, and then clicking on the login button. So now I want to capture the screenshot. So once the test is got executed, I want to capture a screenshot of the test. Okay, so simply we don't need to write any statement because we already done the configuration inside playwright.config.js. So here we have to make it screenshot on. Okay, now let us try to execute the test directly. I'm not writing any additional code for capturing the screenshot. I've done only small change in the configuration file. I just added screenshot on. Okay, all right. So let me open terminal and then execute this command. So npx playwright test, inside the test screenshots2.spec.js, and the project is Chromium, and that I'm executing only on the headed mode. Okay, now it is logged in and my test is also successfully passed. Fine. But where is the screenshot? So we can see the screenshot only on the report, right? And also the screenshot will be automatically saved inside the result folder. If I go and test result folder, here the screenshot will be saved. You can see here, this is a screenshot. And by default, the screenshot will be part of the report also. If you want to see the report, you can simply execute this command, npx playwright show report. That will give you HTML report. You can say npx playwright show -report. So this will give you the report. Now this is a report. Currently we run only one test. Click on it. Now you can see this is a screenshot which is automatically attached here. Okay, so this is how we can capture the screenshot of every test by default. And when you put this configuration, that will capture the screenshot of every test by default. And the screenshot will be saved inside the folder, by default test result folder. And also the screenshot will automatically appear in the reporter. But if you want to capture the screenshot of test, the code level and specification file level, then you have to go to the first approach. We have to write the statement wherever you want to get the screenshot, and whichever element, whichever page, whichever section you want to capture screenshot, you can customize this command screenshot. Okay. So this is the simplest way we can capture the screenshot in Playwright. So you can just go to the document. In the documentation, they have provided everything. And you can just go to playwright.dev, and here you can just search for screenshot. So directly you can go to the page, and you can refer this, how can capture the screenshots. Okay, so that's all for this video. In the next video, we will see another topic. Thanks for watching.